Hello everyone, welcome to One Life Investments. This is me, host Braswell, and in today's video, I'll show you how to try out the Synscwap testnet on ZKSYNC 2.0 and how you can potentially make yourself eligible for a potential airdrop. If you go and look at the airdrop details, if you go down to the campaign details, you can see that community testers who finished all the three testing steps will be granted an honorable alpha tester role. And you can see there's a symbol that looks like a parachute. So I'm assuming this will be an airdrop. They've specifically laid out a process on how you can participate in this. So it looks like there will be some rewards, some incentives for people trying out this first, right? So if you haven't watched our video on how to try out the ZKSYNC testnet 2.0, it's on the top right corner or in the description as well. But this video will also go over those steps where you have to add funds and stuff like that. But if you want to watch that, go ahead and watch that video. But this will be a similar video as well. So first, what you need is you need some Gorelli or GETH. So because it's on testnet, it's on Ethereum's Gorelli networks, so you need some ETH that is accepted on that network. So ETH has different testnets environment, so Gorelli is one of them. So what you need is you need some Gorelli testnet ETH in your MetaMask or whatever browser you are trying to use it from. So one of the ones I use mostly is from Paradigm. So they usually have a lot of funds. So there's limit on how many funds or how much funds will a faucet give out to this users. So if you might struggle to find Gorelli ETH, if you don't have any, let me know. I might be able to find some sources which has some Gorelli ETH, but for this video I'm using Paradigm. So all the links will be in the description as well, so you can just follow along from the links in the description. So I'm gonna go sign in with Twitter. You don't need Twitter or anything like that, it's just a authentication for that matter. So copy and paste your Ethereum address here. So I'm gonna copy Ethereum address. Is this Rinkeby, Robston, Coven, and Gorelli. This might take some time. Usually it says that it's done, but it usually takes a couple of minutes or so for your ETH to roll it. So give it some time, but you should receive, I think it's 0.1. All right, so once you have received some Gorelli ETH or GETH, you want to go to portal.zksync.io because at the moment it is the ETH that you're trying to use is on Gorelli network. You can transfer that to ZKSYNC's own testnet. So once you are at ZKSYNC 2.0 portal, click on connect to MetaMask, click on switch wallet, and it says you must change network. So what you want to do is you want to go to MetaMask and as you can see I have 0.4497 ETH on Gorelli testnet. What you want to do is go back to ZKSYNC, click on MetaMask. Then you have all the funds, and as you can see I have a lot of other assets as well and the balance is quite high, but this is a different wallet that I'm using at the moment as compared to the one I showed you earlier. Because the faucets were dry, there was no Gorelli ETH for me to claim, so I had a wallet. Now once you've connected your wallet, switch network to ZKSYNC testnet. What you want to do is you want to bridge. And what you want to do is, as you can see, Ethereum Gorelli to ZKSYNC assets to ZKSYNC. This will be used for the transactions, fees and stuff like that. So you don't have to transfer a lot. So I'm transferring 0.2 ETH. Was it? And that's fine. Click on and as you can see, it says up to 5 minutes. So it says it will take at least 5 minutes. But once the transfer has gone through, we are ready to use the Synscwap testnet. So go to syncswap.xyz. What you want to do first, you want to go to the faucet and you want to request funds from the faucet. And it says claim tokens and confirm. And the confirm has been successful. So what you've done now is you've claimed some assets. For example, you've claimed some LINK at DAI USDC. And now what we're going to do now is we're going to do some swap. We're going to add liquidity and we're going to remove liquidity. And there's a few things you need. You got to make sure that you take a screenshot of the swap. You take a screenshot of your liquidity pool. And then you need to note down three transaction IDs. The first is the swap transaction ID. Second is your transaction ID where you've added liquidity. And the third one is where you remove liquidity. I'll show you how to get those as well. So first, after you've claimed your tokens, if you see that the network is not correct, make sure you change to ZKSYNC's alpha testnet network. So after that, you just do a couple of swaps. For example, I want to swap from ETH to USDC. example, 0.1 ETH to USDC. Don't get confused with the numbers. It's quite ridiculous, but this is testnet, so it doesn't really matter. Click on swap and confirm. Once this window is confirmed, you want to take a screenshot of this window. What you want to do is you want to click on view and ZK scan. Then you want to note down this transaction ID, and you will need, after you've copied this transaction ID and taken a screenshot of this, you can move to the next step. So close this. Second step is to add liquidity. So go to pool, and as you can see, there's no liquidity. Click on new position, add liquidity to anything. So I'm going to add liquidity for DAI and USDC, for example, 200. And you take a screenshot of not this window, but you close this. You go back, pools overview, and take a screenshot of this window. Right. And for a transaction ID, what you can do is you want to go click on your wallet and you click on these transactions. It will give you the transaction ID. So you want to note that as well. So the final step is to remove the liquidity. Max approve the liquidity pool LP tokens first, and then sign this transaction, and then remove the liquidity. And you're going to make sure that you note down the transaction ID for the removing liquidity as well. Right. So once everything is done, once you've done, you can play around and do other things as well. You can add liquidity to other things, look around and see what this, look around and see if you can find other issues or any suggestions you might have. And the final step is, after you've done all of that, what you want to do is you want to go to the Discord. You want to go to the Discord, and if you go to the participate testing section and you post your Twitter, I forgot to mention that you have to actually have to retweet the status from them, and then you need to enter your wallet address, your swap transaction, liquidity transaction, and LP transaction. Well, so all the details is in the article in the description. If you are confused or if you have any other questions or any issues, let me know. You might run into issue trying to get the Gorilla ETH for sure, but that's out of my hand or anyone else's hands. But so it's what it is, but make sure that you try it every day early in the morning, depending on what time zones are. You should be able to get some Gorilla ETH, right? So I hope that was helpful. I hope that was clear, and hopefully we'll get an airdrop in the future. There's no guarantee again, but if there is one, this will be a process for you to get yourself eligible for that. All right, until next time, if you have any suggestions, any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you're not following me on Twitter, please follow me on Twitter at One Life Investments. And until next time, thank you.